Guess what? We got a lot of shit coming from Saudi Malaysia. Bring on the hundred balls of best for everyone.
In the nightclub world, a whale is somebody who is a really big spender, like a big enough spender to almost single-handedly keep a nightclub viable. So Jolo was the biggest of the whales, the blue whale among whales. The first time we heard about him, Jolo had gone to this club, One Oak. He saw Lindsay Lohan, and somebody had told Jolo that it was her 23rd birthday. So he bought 23 bottles of champagne for the club. It comes out with the waitresses put sparklers in it, and they run around the room and everybody cheers. And then somebody approached him apparently and said, hey, you know, you've kind of been played with here, it's not her birthday. And kind of, I think, sort of an act of defiance, but also I think just having fun with it, he ordered another 23 bottles.
Paris Hilton was allegedly charging Jolo $1 million every time she went to be his party companion.
He had hired Busta Rhymes to do some kind of personal party, Jamie Foxx and Swiss Beats.
They were giving each other party presents of Bugattis to drive away on. And then there were all dancing dwarves and caged lions by the pool and acrobats. They'd get someone like Britney Spears jumping out of birthday cakes.
Everyone's wondering, how is it that this fat Chinese boy gets to party with all the hottest girls in Hollywood?
So it all came together really late 2013 as the promotional stuff came out for a movie, The Wolf of Wall Street.
My name is Jordan Belfort. The year I turned 26, I made $49 million, which really pissed me off because it was three shy of $1 million a week.
But I'd also discovered that the producer of this movie, this $100 million movie about squandering stolen money, was the stepson of Najib Razak.
I mean, to have, you know, the pedigree of talent with, you know, really